Okay, so today, what do I need? I need to import. We'll do a bunch of things to do with armatures and resources again and models. A bit more refinement. First thing I need to do is import the correct armature root node. So I imagine what I had here for armature loading was it just loaded the base. Okay, so let's have a look at this. Import armature, which will go into this. Not quite. For precisely was import armature. Okay. Okay, all right. So, right now I'm just importing the entirety of the armature. Not exactly what I'm looking for, but I really need. Although, it can be close. So let's go to this point. Let's do a quick run and see that there's errors right now, so not happening. A lot of errors. Why exactly? No visible conversion from. Are you sure about that? Okay, that's we can do that. Did I? Oh, right, yes. Okay. I updated the Vulcan header, so. Imagine that this one still only has. Up to 172, and I'm using 173 right now, so git pull to latest. Should have 173. Yeah, we'll be good again. V173. Oop, cancel. I just want to add that one. Put that in. Okay. Back to where I was. So armature is several nodes, starting with the root node, cube tower. Tower armature. So what I can do is I can rip out these guys. And just convert that to the root. Okay. Armature file names, armature root node. Armature. Temp armature. We'll do that. Then we'll have to go through auto search iterator equals. I need to go through. Can I just do it as part? Yeah, I can probably just do it as part of the loop. That search iterator, just we'll just put down iterator equals, not equals the end. We'll go through until we find it. If iterator name equals armature root node name, then we will, what will we do? We'll just take from this point to the end. So can I copy or because I just want to get like this to the end. Iterator to temp armature to the end. And put it in armature. Yeah, it's not quite gonna end correctly, is it? All right. Let's look at containers standard vector. CPP reference. See what we got. I mean, I could resize doesn't. No. Initializer list vector. Assign. That looks like what we can do. Okay. So this starts at tower armature and goes to bottom, middle, or upper, top end. Okay. Which means that right now it's missing the other bottom two, which is the cube tower and the root node. So that's better. That's going to screw up animation, though. Because at the moment... Actually, I'm not entirely sure. Their bones... I'm not sure what the bone layout actually is. Have a quick little look. So cyclosphere, that'll be cube. This will be the one I'm looking for right here. Okay, so mesh bones, we had graphics bones, sorry, we have top, mid, upper, middle, lower, and bottom. Okay, so no, this shouldn't actually, because the animation right now is actually just doing matching them up near dynamically, correct? If we every time we come through. Matching them up on the animation channel. Are we? Well, first of all, I'll turn animation back on so I can actually see it. Okay. So I'm not actually. I'm building these each time. Which is okay, but I'll probably actually want to keep like animation bone or armature information for other items, like such as physics engines and what have you, or for interacting. Determining the where to position in the arm without having to recalculate it every time. Because we've got to calculate it once at least. We may as well then just store it in memory and then maybe just copy it into this if we need it. But that sounds like some kind of future stuff, really. So that's still going right. No, that's not doing anything. Oh, I didn't actually, nope. Okay. So it's going through the animation stuff, but it's not actually firing off. Is it to do with this? Nope, it's just not doing anything. Why? We're just not importing. Did I muck something up? No, this is basically. Right, this isn't the XR, this is the regular. Yes, this is. Generate bone animation. Nope, we're going in here. We're getting something. Position 000. Yeah, okay. But the point is, we're not actually doing a transform of zero, of nothing at all. Ever. Okay, let's back this up. Oh, this is still. Oh. Nope, nope, still screwed. Okay. Great. Why is it? Oh, no, it's also because of this. Oh my God, I gotta. And then there they go. Okay. So armatures now load using the correct root node. Okay, so that's that. Add support for multiple animations for each file. Okay, so this is based on the idea that I would have, yeah. I'd have to get the animation from multiple files, but okay, hold on. Now, can we, is that what we're doing here? Or is it always, so it is from two of them, yeah? Bounce and self curl. So we are loading that one in, right? Correct. Okay, the bounce is happening. Okay. But, oh, it's a, okay, I see what it is now. It's supposed to be a optimization, so I can have multiples here. Okay. So that's going to require armature, there you are. Animation name, or be a vector of strings. Okay. That'll work for strings, or maybe not. I don't know. Whatever the case may be, it's now a vector of strings. That's what we're going to be returning for animation import information, which means down here on armature public data. Animations node, here we go. it's not a readable node. Instead, it's a do that, and then for each of them, read the node, it's not that, it's a star reiterator. It goes in temp string. That temp string goes into the animation. Dot. Move that in. Or dot. Else we'd throw some error out here later. That's later. Back here. Got the thing, we're going through the animations. Probably something we would want to do after this. Once we've read all the animations for that file, oh, we'd also have to go through and make sure like all the animation names are unique combinations or something on that order. Later. But when we go back to armature, we want to go through and check if gotta go through these guys. Animation names. If it equals iterator. Let's import animation name, then we import it. Breakout. I don't really. Yeah, whatever. Ah, good. It broke. Loading resource, going into the import. Invoker, libyaml, read required for string. Sorry, which one are we talking about? File name. Okay. Stop that. File name and animations, they're part of the same node. Okay. That looks a bit better. Pairs. So minor and minor update. What's something that could be done quickly? As both for multiple. Da, da, da. Let's get that. Okay, publicize resources. I don't really want to touch that. What I probably do want to do though is I want to do something about these files. These files are just starting to clutter up the main root folder. And I think it's time to move them out. Okay. Presumably into the data folder for these test resources. Okay, let's get this out of the way at least. Full render. Okay. That's out of the way. Okay. So outstate data. The original idea was that I mean, this is still the idea for binary, but the original idea was to have all of it in one large file. Unfortunately, this is an okay idea. At least everything will be together. But as the state data grows and you have more and more entities with more and more components, this will become unwieldy to use in a version control system. Nigh on impossible, I'd say. I need to be able to split all this out. Like, originally this would have like all these resources would be, you know, merged into this one larger file, along with the state data, the index data, dependency information. It would just grow, and you'd have like a large, you know, giant diffs all the time of everything. And that'd be a bit unmanageable, really, honestly and truly. So what I need to do is I need to split it out into a more long-term solution. And that really has to be, like, it has to be, at least for development, I should say. Development should be split up into individual files for different entity information. Binaries, of course, like binary information. One file, whatever. That's not what most people will be modifying. So what would probably have to be, what would have to eventually have to be, would be, rather than like the state data being like the data whatever, it'd be more along the lines of, you'd have the data A, you'd have this. Inside of that, you'd have dependencies.yaml. Index data, YAML, and then you'd have, I guess, two directories. You'd have resources, and then you'd have state data. And then resources will be these, but then, of course, they'll be split up further into, let's say, shader. Or rather, just shader, singular, vertex descriptors, armature, mesh, material, okay. I'll try to split. Maybe I'm not entirely sure how to split state data on a particular group. Unless it's some kind of arbitrary one, really. It could be. But at least for the case of resources, I'll be able to like properly segment down. To a certain extent, that is. I think. Oh, image as well, yeah. Would mean, of course, this will be a lot more interesting to. Well, no, it'd be basically the same. Yeah, I think I'll go with this. Okay, I'm going to grab a drink and then I'm going to start making this happen. Okay. So, first thing. Which one is this? This is like what? E, I presume? The data E? Okay.
So dependencies, well, because of that, move it over to that. Doesn't have to be part of a sub thing, it's just this. Simple as that. Would it be a sub? Yeah, it'd be a subdirectory. Okay. D has these for dependencies. Just nothing. And A has also got nothing, right? Yeah. Oh no, E, I've got actually this technically. Okay. Source, application. I think all this stuff is still in the application area. Or not? Wait, did I lose? Is it like a sub? Save load. Okay, thank God I still have it in another branch. Am I done with this for the moment? Yeah, I kind of am for model. So we'll just right, there's no mert. Yeah. Just push this up. And then go to mainline, merge it once it succeeds. Just wait for it to pass, and then I'll see if there's anything to fix up. Then I'll merge and move on. Okay, just a minor issue with armature loader. One of these files. Not you, supposedly. What? Include full resource armature loader. Supposedly has. Oh, yeah, okay. There you are. F. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Still good. Okay. Merge that in. We'll push that up, and then we'll push that up later. Save load. Rebase on the main line, which was no problem at all, apparently. Yeah, here we go. The root node, the index nodes, and all that lovely stuff. Okay. What we're going to do probably is split this up a little bit. Why is this here? When did I add this? Implemented in a simple animation system. Okay, so we delete this. Okay. When was this? Guess the origin model, origin main. Added function to get dummy. So it goes back to the fixed minor formatting issue. Okay, you know what? Actually, just do that. That's easier. No longer have that extra folder, that's great. Oh God. Now we have problems. They look exactly the same. What? Okay, except current change. Current change. Current change. Okay. That's the file we got rid of, so now we're clear. Check log. That's the old model, this is the new model. And we have this save load on top of that, that's great. Let's go back up here. If thinks we have problems, that's fine. Okay, YAML state, which will be a CMake lists. Which we'll prefix with state. So we have state YAML and then state binary. Hiding in the source files currently. I guess we'll just kind of do something like this. So what are we going to do? We're going to have like a function that when, okay, where's our entry point for this? It's loads, I think it's load state data, right? That's the entry point for this. Load state data, that. Okay. So it won't be a file system path to begin with. File system. Be a direct. Is it a directory entry? What's a directory entry? No. That's an entry on a directory. So can a path be a directory? Checks if whether a given path is a directory. Okay. So we can still take in, okay. first thing we'll do is we'll determine. If it's not a directory, then we're just going to trash it. I already know it's an error. There are certain macros for finding like the file look. I think native is the one that works with Windows. Otherwise, we can carry on to do the usual. By default, false. Actually, it doesn't really matter. What other types are there? Is directory, is file, block device, is character device. Sorry, character device? What's a character device? Checks if given file status or path corresponds to a special character file, such as dev, null, del, yeah, okay. Checks if file status or path corresponds to a regular file. That's what I'm looking for. So wait, can I this regular file? Standard file system file status. What's this? How can I get this? I won't even bother actually. It is single file. Okay. Of course, it would still have to be able to go back to look at the binary side as well, which I'm not going to implement yet still. Import. Okay, we have to go for dependencies anyways. Top level dependencies, which should be basically this. You know what? I'm not even going to bother with the file. It just has to be, it's just a directory. That's it. Okay? Nothing else. Not going to support more than I have to. Will be basically this. State dependency data is this. For group ID, which is brought in from this. These two. Interesting. I need to return multiple things, really. Because I need to return a false as well. And I don't want to use exceptions in here. Any more than I have to, I should say. Because I still have to use them for the YAML. The YAML library still uses exceptions, but I don't want to have them spill outside of this import or export file. I mean, I could. Honestly, could. But I'm not going to fall for it. What I'm going to do is... going to do this, and instead we're just going to return a bool. Good old-fashioned boolean. Is this... If not that, then we're going to return false. This. I thought file system could do this. File system path. Operator this. Appends element to the path with directory separator. Yeah, that should work. Const chart, really? It can't accept that. What if I just do a string view, eh? Do you like that? Do that. Mm.
checking errors. Redefinition of, yeah. So we got the dependencies file, then we gotta actually open it. Or wait, no, that can. If I recall correctly, there's like a load file, right? iStream. Okay, so no, yeah, I can just pass the file in as it is into it. Okay. Then we'd actually do this. And we'd have another function, which is just this, almost the same thing. But it takes in the YAML node instead. If it's from file, then we already have the node, and then we're passing the node that we're already trying to parse. So we don't need this bit, just need this part down here. It's not going to be quite that. It's going to be my own exception type instead.
FoeYAML. FoeYAML exception. Like that. Okay, for dependencies node, that. Then we add state dependencies and place it on back. New dependency equals that. Really? No member named value. I'm sorry. File. Okay. Use when declared to identify import state dependencies. Really? Are you sure about that? Because of this still. This has to be like a standard string, right? Oh my god. Really? Okay. I cannot possibly believe that this is just not going to happen. This seems... Append operator. Source, input, first and last. Okay. Okay. And it becomes this, right? No. Am I just... Use an undeclared identifier this. Okay, hold on. First of all, can I make a string? Okay, cool. This is... something else way out of the way. I don't care. Yes, I can do this. Can I do this? Yeah. Can I then do this? Okay, first of all, it should be from file. And then this is like... okay, these things are all way out of here, so I don't know why you're complaining still. Just trying to ruin my day, I presume. Okay. Okay. So then at this point, we start moving on to the other little cool little thing. So. And we'd have the group translations, which are like... it's not, wait, it's not there yet. We only pulled in that.
dependencies, transitive dependencies. Okay. So one of the first things we'll be in will be state dependencies. Oh, yeah, and I need to be able to say, I need to specify. I need to specify it. The name of the state group that I'm working with. Which would inherit from the last of the path, if I recall correctly. So, sneak on back down here. For a path, it's a what? What is it? Is this a path? This is a path. Stem. This will be the last bit. Tar baz bar. Okay. So stem. Native. Let's do this. See if we can get this working so I can actually check it at this point. Import HPP state data dot native. Yeah, okay. We go to here, we got IT that file name and stuff. State data dependency. Are you sure? Okay, right, yeah, because it's now path. Path, path.
Now, where we load state data dependencies, or rather load state data down here. So it should be, well, technically, these should all be sitting in data right now. Okay, top level group name, the data E, good. Okay, that means we'll do that. We'll have string view of group name. Import state. So it'd be like more group state rather than just state. Group dependencies, da, da, da. Group name, da, da. Import group state. That sounds a lot better than just right. State is too generic. Group state, though, makes a bit more sense. It's the state of the group. Yes. We have dependent groups that we depend upon. All right. So we've checked for duplicates. Then we move on to, there we go, duplicates, finding dependent files, check for transitive dependencies. Group state files / folders. So we got to go through state dependencies. We got to find them. For this, I need to roll back to what I had a while back for search paths. I'm going to have to bring search paths into this. Oh, what fun. Okay, grab a drink of water first and carry on this. Okay. Search paths. Do I even have search paths in here anymore? No, I do not. So, let's begin. Search paths. Or, actually, rather, I should probably put this No, for the moment, it's just here. It's localized. That's what we're going to do. All right. Data state. Now, what do I? Do I want to actually search for it before I enter here, or do I just want to like import state this and search for it? No. Yeah, because this will already be a known quantity. You're like you've selected this. Well, this is a specific save file. So we'll just pass in the search paths as they are. Can't be that, it has to be a pointer. Because it has to be modifiable. I could do a reference, but we'll just do a reference. Okay, yeah, find us. We just gotta go through and find them. That's basically all we can do. So, and iterator, find them. Check if it exists, but it can't be this. Find group. Group name and follow search paths.
That'd be an out. First of all, let's see if we can find it locally. Or, hold on, do I have search paths? I have file system. No. Reader, search paths. Okay. No, don't check from the local position first. Always go through the search paths. Search paths can include the local position, but I want to do it in the order. The search paths order. So, auto reader. It's not try, right? It's git will block until blocks until acquired. Mark of dependencies.yaml. Oh, this thing again. God. Dang it. Okay, so group state path equals temp return true. Does reader automatically destroy itself? I sure hope it does.
Good. Good. Sorry. If not that, then cannot find dependency this for group state, la 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 la, group name. Search paths, and then we have it dot. Sorry. No, it's it dot name is the one we're looking for here. Dot path. Okay. Oh yeah, then I need to import from the node. Needs to go the other way around here. Looking for a group name, the data A. We have multiple paths we can check. So the first path we're checking is data state, the data A. We found it. We'll add it to directory. We'll return that. That means state dependencies. Implementation. Come on. What is this? Okay, return true. Okay. What's next on the checks for dependencies? Find dependent check transitive dependencies. So state dependencies begin and okay, load state dependencies, which is basically the same as this, isn't it? Again. Okay, which means I have it from this right now. It's going to be from this. Use of undeclared identifier that load. Oh, yeah. No matching call for this. Are you sure? Oh, yes. top level group. And return false. Otherwise, we check the could not find transitive dependency for group. For dependency group. For top level group that. If we get through that, that means that's the last of the transitive dependencies. That's the last of the dependency checks. And these are items. These are actually items I can check. Add tests for in due time. What's the time? Nearly 2 hours. Oh, okay. Okay, so I have this. If from file. And then I have to get into the group. Okay, whatever. I'm going to leave this. It's 2 hours. I'm tired, exhausted. I'll leave index data and stuff for next time. Cheers.